In this segment, we're going to take an example of floating point representation. So we're going to take a hypothetical example because in a regular single precision number, you'll have to use, people use 32 bits. So if you're using 32 bits and then you have certain bits for the sign of the number, then you'll have certain bits for the exponent of the number and certain bits for the mantissa of the number. But since we're talking about 32 bits, that might be too many bits to write down on the board. So that's why I'm going to take a hypothetical word for your floating point representation. But you should understand how things are really stored in real life. In single precision, you'll be using 32 bits to have a single precision number. So let's go and look at this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take an 8-bit word. So what we're assuming is that we have a floating point representation in which is going to use 8 bits. And I'm going to distribute now these bits. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And this, for example, is, let's suppose, used for the sign of the number. And this one is used for a sign of exponent. Generally, there is no bit used for the sign of exponent in real life because they use a biased exponent. We'll take that example in another segment. But to keep things simple, to be able to understand what floating point representation is all about, we are using one bit for the sign of the exponent. And then I'm going to use 3 bits. I'm going to use 3 bits. This is 1, 2, and 3 bits for the exponent itself. And the rest of the 3, I'm going to use for the mantissa. So I have 8-bit word. The first bit is going to use for the sign of the number. The second bit is going to use for the sign of the exponent. The next 3 are going to be used for the exponent itself. And the next 3 are going to use for the mantissa. That makes a total of 8. So if somebody tells me, hey, go ahead and put minus 13.9 to the base 10 into the floating point. Can you represent this number, minus 13.9, into a floating point representation when you are given that you have an 8-bit word? First bit is used for the sign of the number. Second bit is used for the sign of the exponent. Next 3 for the exponent itself, and next 3 for the mantissa. Take this number, minus 13.9, in the base 10, and put it in the floating point representation. So let's go and see how we can go about doing that. So we have minus 13.9 to the base 10. That's our number which we want to be able to convert to our floating point representation, right? So the first thing which we have to do is that we have to convert 13 into base 2. And 13 in base 2 is 1101. And I'm going to leave this as homework because we already talked about binary representation. So go ahead and see that how 13 is same as 1101 base 2. The same thing, 0.9 in the base 10 will be 0 radix point 11100 base 2. And this will be an approximation because, again, as we learned in binary representation, 0.9 cannot be represented exactly, but these are the first 5 digits which you have of zeros and ones after the radix point for the representation of 0.9. So this, again, I'm going to leave this as your homework. So once you have done these 2 pieces of homework, what I can write down is that minus 13.9 to the base 10 is nothing but 1101, then the radix point 1100 base 2, and this is an approximation, of course, and then the minus sign right here because I have a minus sign right there. Now, in order to be able to write down the floating point representation, what I have to do is I have to say minus 1.10100 base 2. So what I've done here is that I have to move this radix point all the way up to here because I have to have the first, the number before the radix point has to be a 1. So in order to be able to do that, it can be only one, nothing else. It cannot be zero. It cannot be more than one. So it is just one. So that means I have to move the radix point all the way three places to the left here. So that's why I get one radix point, 101 from here, and then the three ones which are right here, and so on and so forth. Multiply by 2 to the power 3. The reason why it's 2 to the power 3 is because I move the radix point three places to the left here. So if that is the case, I'm going to again approximate it by minus 1.101 base 2 times 2 to the power 3. And the reason why I'm doing that is because I can only I only have three places for the mantissa. So I'm going to, rather than writing down the whole number or the longer version of the number, I'm going to just say it's approximately minus 1 radix point 101 and forget about these ones because I cannot represent them anyway. In the mantissa, I only have places for three bits, so it'll be the bit after the radix point, 101. This is automatically taken into consideration because every floating point representation will have a 1 before the radix point, so I don't need to store that. So 101 will be stored in the mantissa. Now, I already know that the sine bit of the number is negative, so I'll have a 1 in the sine bit. I'll have 101 in the mantissa, but I still got to figure out what is the sine of the exponent and what is the value of the exponent. Now, I only know the sine, 2 raised to the power 3, the sine of the exponent is positive, so I'll have a 0 in the sine of the exponent. So I got to figure out what to do with this 3 now. So 3, again, I know that it is 1 base 2. And since I have three bits in the exponent, I'm going to put as 0, 1, 1 base 2. Again, I'm going to leave this as homework for you to show me that why 3 is 1, 1 base 2. Now, why did I put a 0 here is because I have three places for my exponent. So since it is 1, 1 base 2, in order to be able to fill up the third space, I'll put the 0 in the front, which does not make any difference to the number equivalent, which is still 3. So I'll have 0, 1, 1 there. So let me go ahead and write down the whole number now in the base 2 format, and that will make it very clear that what numbers go where.